Good morning, students. Let us begin our online classes. And now we'll start our second part of the chapter, okay? Now see, students, in the first part, we have studied about granaries, great bath, plus the different cities emerged, okay, their dress, ornaments, etc. Now, let us begin with the second part in which we'll start about the trade of the people. Okay. Now here, trading in Harappan civilization, it was conducted according to the set of rules. Okay. Now, trade was first carried on with Mesopotamia and Afghanistan. Iran. Okay. Now, students, here we may also say that tin, which was mixed with the copper to produce bronze, it was bought from Afghanistan and Iran. Okay. Now, trade was also from the port of Lothal. If you see here, there are different things made and it was bought from the different places. Now, gold was bought from Karnataka. Okay, gold was bought from Karnataka and copper was obtained from Khetri mines of Rajasthan and also from Balochistan. Okay, now the merchants used uniform weights and measures. Means, uniform means a proper particular weight and measures. Okay, even in this I may say that copper, gold, silver, semi-precious stones, these were bought in form of Persia, Oman, Afghanistan and Gujarat. Means all these things were bought from Persia, Oman, Afghanistan and Gujarat. Okay, now see, in this you will find the different seals. Seals means it is of a rectangular shape and also the square shape. Okay. Now, they carried short inscriptions with the pictures of carved animals on them. Okay. Means on the seals, if you see here, there are the pictures of the animals and they used to carry the seals of the picture of the animals with them. Okay. Now, variety of seals have been found from these sites, plus they have pictorial motifs and inscriptions on them. Okay. Now, most of the seals have either a bull, peepal tree or Pashupati. Okay. Means most of the seals are of bull, peepal tree or Pashupati. And what message they convey? They convey that all these three would have been worshipped by the people of those times. Okay, means the worshippings, how we worship God, and the seals were for the worshipping. Okay, now they also provide a lot of information about the daily life of the people and their religious beliefs. Okay, now this is all about the seals. Now let us proceed with our next topic, that is new crafts in the city or art and crafts. Okay, now see, the Indus Valley people were skilled in the art of mixing copper and tin, okay, to form an alloy. And here most of the things were made of stones, shell and metal, including copper, bronze, gold and silver. Okay, now, the most striking finds are those of beads, weights and blades. Okay. Even the Harappans also made the seals out of stones. Now see, just now I told you that even they used to make the seals. Okay. Now, a piece of woven cotton has been recovered from Mohenjo-daro. Okay. Now, even they discovered a piece of cotton, okay, woven cotton, and how they recovered it with the help of spindle wools, and this spindle wools they were used for spinning. Okay, now even with all those things, as I told you that the Harappans were also expert in bead making, pottery and many more things. Okay, now our next part is religious beliefs. As I told you that they used to worship the seals in the form of religious god, but still I'll tell you that here in the picture, if you see the figure of mother goddess, okay, here you will see the picture of mother goddess and peepal tree. Okay, now the Indus people worship Pashupati. I told you when I was teaching you seal also that the peepal tree, the Pashupati, that is you may say Lord Shiva. Okay, they used to worship bull, peepal tree and Lord Shiva. Okay, here he is represented on a seal. Even the seal they used, even the picture of Lord Shiva or Pashupati, it was represented on the seal. And he has three heads and has horns. Okay, he has three heads and has horns. And even he was surrounded by an elephant, a tiger, a rhinoceros and buffalo. Okay, now they buried their dead in large earthen pots along with the food and the ornaments. Okay, even there were some fire altars which were probably used as places for sacrifices. Okay, now the next is scripts. Okay, now what do you mean by script? This scripts were nothing but a pictographic. Okay, it is a pictographic script of the Indus Valley civilization, and it have been found on the seals. Okay, it is considered to be one of the world's earliest known scripts, and even it is assumed that the script is written from right to left. How it is written? It is written from right to left. And also there are about to 400 pictographs. Okay, how many pictographs are there? 400. And the script has not been decipherd so far. Okay, now this is all about the script. Now students, when the decline of Indus Valley civilization started? See, first of all, the decline was because of the climatic change. It was also because of the floods, that is Indus River changed course, which affected the food production also. And the climate was too dry to support farming. Floods, soil exhaustion, people migrated to the other parts. And scholars think that the Dravidian people who now live in southern India may be descended from the Indus Valley civilization. And slowly, slowly, this people started migrating. Okay. Now, let us study in detail about the Harappan cities in Gujarat. That is, your first city is Dholavira. Now see, where does the Dholavira lies? It lies in the Khadir Island and it is in the run of Kutch. Okay. Secondly, it is one of the largest settlement in India, and fifth sites have been discovered. Now, Dholavira was divided into three parts, that is a citadel, middle town and lower town. Okay, now see, if you see the picture, it was also divided into three parts, and each part was surrounded with the massive stone walls. Okay, and here with the entrance you will have the gateways. Okay, this is all about Dholavira. Now your next city in this is Lothal. First of all, Lothal is a Gujarati word. Okay, Lothal is a Gujarati word and it means the place of dead. What does it mean? It means a place of dead. Now, the city of Lothal, it stood beside a tributary of Sabarmati in Gujarat and it is close to the Gulf of Kamba. Okay. Now, raw materials such as semi-precious stones were easily available here. It was also an important center for making stone shells and metals. Okay. And there were many seals and sealings found, plus pieces of stones, half-made beads, tools of reds and finishing beads were also found over here. Okay. Now, the next is Goladoro. Goladoro, it is recently excavated site in the Kutch. Plus, it was famous for shells and coppers. And it was here also a unique seal has been found in Goladoro. Okay. And also, this seal, it was shaped like a box and all means it was very beautiful. Okay. Now, this is all about this chapter, students. Thank you. And I hope you have understood. Now I'll update you the answers and exercise. Please note it down in your classwork copy. Okay. Thank you.